Another reason you and I need to appreciate and see the beauty of God's hand in human creation is this: culture and background affect who we are. Culture and background affect who we are. The color of your skin is tied to your culture and your background. Think about this for a moment, folks. How do you and I really get to know someone? Better yet, how do we actually follow Jesus' missional command when it comes to relationships? And what is Jesus' missional command when it comes to relationships? It's found in Mark's Gospel, chapter 12. A group of people, and then it was singled out to one man, Jesus. What is the greatest commandment? Jesus said this: you shall love the Lord your God with all of your heart, with all of your soul, with all of your mind, and with all of your strength. This is the first commandment, and the second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these. Wow. If you want to know what the greatest commandment is to follow, that is the greatest commandment to follow. Did you notice that Jesus put them together? He tied them together. He said, oh, there's this one, but then there's this one. But really, there's just one. What was Jesus saying? He was saying this: if you can't love your neighbor as yourself, different color of skin, different culture, different background, if you can't love that neighbor as you love yourself, then you really don't love God with all your body, your soul, your mind, and your strength. Amen. Or you can tout that you do. You can wave a flag that, oh, I love God so much, but I hate that neighbor. He said, you do not love God with all of your body, with all of your soul, with all of your strength until you love that neighbor as you love yourself. I want to teach, not preach. There is a scene in the Star Wars trilogy. We got some Star Wars fans here in the house, so you understand where I'm going with this particular scene, and you'll be able to take me there quicker than I can. But there's this really swanky establishment, and Luke Walker with his endless droids wants to visit this establishment. I mean, the people there are weird looking. They are gross. They're just out there. And they're listening to music, and they're just having this really weird food, and you know, CP3O and R2D2, they, you know, sidekicks of Luke Skywalker, and then they walk into this establishment. You know where I'm at, right? You Star Wars fan, you know where I'm at. So they walk into this place, and you know, they're there to be waited on, just like everybody else who looks weird. And quite honestly, Luke Skywalker is C-3PO and R2-D2, they look normal compared to the rest of the folks. And there is this scene as they're making their way into this establishment where there is a rebuttal, quite a curt rebuttal, I should say, from one of the weird creatures. I want to quote it: we don't serve their kind here. We don't serve their kind here. That strange sci-fi clip, I think, captures a generational curse and the relational struggle we have on planet Earth. It's a fact of life. We are always more comfortable with people who are just like us. So think about that just for a moment. What condition would you be in right now if Jesus abided by that fact of life? I mean, what would your future look like without Jesus? We know he was divine. We know he was perfect in every way. The Bible tells me so. He was tempted in all ways, just like you and I are tempted, yet he was without sin. So therefore, he was perfect. Would you agree with that this morning? So that makes him far different than you and me. Yet the Bible says he came to dwell among us. Yet he came to dwell among us. John said it like this. He was in the beginning with God, for he was God. Saved in the beginning with God. We beheld his glory like as that of the Son of God. And then verse 14 says, and that glory of God came and dwelt among us. Let me explain us, people of a different kind. He was perfect. We are not. He was divine. We are not. He was all that God could ever be in the flesh. We are not. He, full of God's glory and God's goodness and God's grace, yet he came and he dwelt among us. Not only did he dwell among us, he died.